wish we could. And so nothing has looked the same since we awoke from a slumber to see the heart of darkness and came to live with the souls of heroes. And in defense of liberty, summon a call to arms. The tides of history and the change in seasons are impossible to predict. Winter in Utah arrived thunderously after Thanksgiving, heralded by a typical blanket of snow across the Wasatch Front. Slowly falling flakes, dry and powdery, accumulating not by inches but feet, deep enough to paint a landscape of utter tranquility, a world as we wish it could be. Sixteen months after the Olympic flame was extinguished, an ocean away and a long time ago, it's about to be rekindled in a country thrust without warning to the center of history.
On a mountainside in Salt Lake City tonight, the 19th Olympic Winter Games will not convene with a simple ceremony of innocence, but a ceremony of resonance, where nations have come together to imagine a world as we wish it could be, where flags fly with pride, but not prejudice, where men and women are not judged by the circumstances of their birth or beliefs, but only by the depth of their character and their imagination. The snows have left behind sheets of white for the athletes of the world to write their own stories. Like the vulnerable world champion, newly independent, about to be tested by fearless teens from home, and a flourishing star from abroad. What will be the color of her latest Olympic chapter? And inside a charged arena, a charismatic Canadian pair will dare to unseat a Russian dynasty four decades long. We await another winter game shaped by G-forces and omega curves, method air and back scratchers. Another trick turn from Mr. Helly Mute Grab. We await a new wave of American talent like the Ivy Leaguer who turned double plays into Daffies. The teenager from Seattle who goes by three names and could win just as many medals. And the inliner from Miami, who took her fire from the street to the ice. On Utah's snow-swept summits, we'll see if a California Golden Boy and a New Hampshire Free Spirit can make the most of the home mountain advantage. We await others for whom these games are nothing more and nothing less than a story of hope and healing. We await others who get up when they fall and make real the miraculous. Since that morning without reason, we have seen the strength of ideas when they're made real. Tonight, a parade of nations has assembled on a mountainside in Utah to make real these self-evident truths. That what unites us can be far greater than what divides us. And that we are beaten only when we stop believing in what we wish we can be. The flame that is lit tonight is not like any other. It is not the fire of destruction, but a light in the darkness. The Olympic torch has arrived in Salt Lake City, about to conclude a journey of some 13,500 winding miles through 46 states, including, for the first time, Alaska. The road ends tonight at the opening ceremony of the 19th Olympic Winter Games, which will conclude with the traditional lighting of the cauldron, the identity of the final torch bearer, as always, a closely kept secret. Temperature tonight, 30 degrees, wind chill of 15 and falling. We've had a dusting of snow here this morning, more in the surrounding mountains, and 52,000 are in attendance tonight at Rice-Eccles Olympic Stadium on the University of Utah campus. It's the largest crowd ever for a winter opening ceremony. And welcome to our coverage of the opening ceremony of the 19th Olympic...
...of God Bless America.
God bless America, land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the wide with foam. God bless America, my home sweet home. God bless America, my land that I love. Stand beside her and guide her through the night with a light from above. From the mountains to the prairies to the oceans wide with foam.
Next, when we return to Salt Lake City, Bob Costas will be speaking live here in the stadium with President George Bush.
Olympic team and by the Home Depot, proud sponsor of the Salt Lake 2002 Olympic Winter Games.
I got the chance to tell the U.S. athletes how proud we were of them, and I ended by saying, let's roll. I told them that the country was pulling for them, and that in itself was a thrill, but I can't wait to see this. It's going to be magnificent.
Everybody knows what a big baseball fan you are and football fan. Do you have any special Olympic memories from following the Olympics through the years?
Oh, Bobby Morrow. I grew up in West Texas, and he was a West Texan.
Right. Sprinter, once the fastest man in the world.
Absolutely. That's probably the most my most fond memory as a kid.
Was there ever a time, shifting subjects here, after September 11th, when you thought these games wouldn't or shouldn't be held?
No, never did. First of all, I knew we could secure the arena and secure the venue. I also knew that if the games weren't held, it would be a victory for the terrorists, and we're not going to let them have any victories.
Last week, America had a very successful Super Bowl, but the security procedures were unprecedented. And now this has been called the largest security event in the history of the United States, these Olympics. Given the perilous world in which we live, should we consider the possibility that this could be our last Olympic Games as the host?
Nah. We're learning how to make America more secure. As a matter of fact, what happened at the Super Bowl and is happening here is going to be a go-by for other venues around the world. I mean, we're in a different world, no question about it. But we are not going to let terrorists shut us down. And the United States is going to host a lot of big events, and we're going to be better at securing those events.
Being the President of the United States is obviously a stressful job, even more so, I would think, in extraordinary times like these. How are your energies and spirits these days?
It's never been better. I'm spiritually strong. I feel the prayers of the people. And I'm running well. I mean, I'm running a lot. And I take about an hour a day. I'm running 21-minute 3 miles. And I don't know, whatever it is, I feel great.
What's the importance of events like the World Series, which you attended, the
yes.
Super Bowl, and now these Winter Olympics, in reestablishing a national mood?
Well, I think the series, this is a little different. This is an international venue. This is a chance for people from all around the world to come in the midst of war and have a peaceful competition, fierce competition, but peaceful. In other words, this is a statement for peace and unity. The series was a chance for a great city and our nation to start a healing process. And, you know, the Yanks mean so much to the people of New York, and everybody's pulling for the Yanks, and they were cheering for the Yanks. And all of a sudden, the more they cheered, the less sorrow they felt. And while none of us will ever forget 9/11, that baseball event was really a part of a kind of a chance to move beyond the evils that happened on that day.
Mr. President, we're all glad you're here. Enjoy yourself tonight.
Thanks, Bob. Great to see you again.
Thanks very much. Good to see you too. And we'll return to the opening ceremony for the 19th Winter Olympic Games from Salt Lake City, Utah, right after this.